the Mississippi River watershed is a world-class river, and it drains a long distance, it drains a lot of water, and there's a lot of activity within that watershed that can cause problems with the nutrient levels. We're generating data, we're entering data, we're up as well. The second speakers are going to talk more about their programs. The amount of fresh water that came in this year was more than we've had in a long time. The Bonnet Carey spillway was opened twice this year, and that has not happened in recent history. But we had 97 stations that we covered over this entire area, and 47 of them fell below the value of 2 milligrams per liter. Fisheries, oysters, crabs, fish, those declined because of all the fresh water. If you're trawling for shrimp over this area, any of this area that's outlined in black, there will be no shrimp on the bottom, because they can sense the dissolved oxygen going down and they start to migrate away from it. Looking at the numbers from since 1985, and this year's number was close to some of the largest numbers. And I estimated that the size this year was about the size of the land area of the state of New Jersey. And so that's an indication of how large it was. And the darker red is anything less than 1. So it wasn't just low, it was quite low in some areas. Our largest area to date was in 2017, and it approached the size of about Massachusetts. The peak that we had in March, and then the extended peak that we had in May through July, was well above the long-term high. Mm-hmm. Other areas in the world, when you reduce the nutrients, you can improve the water quality. And it's not just the Gulf of Mexico. The watershed has these same toxic cyanobacterial blooms, these blue-green algal blooms that are harmful to children, dogs, people, and nitrate levels in drinking water often exceeds the safe standards. And